President Calderón, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.
I want to ask you, because our positioning now as Miami Business School is very much focused on sustainable business. And last week, the Business Roundtable in the United States shifted its focus from a shareholder society to a stakeholder society. You've been very much committed to the environment and to climate change mitigation. What do you see the future of this sustainable business arena being?
Well, first, thanks and congratulations, Dean, about such decision. And second, yes, indeed, I'm very committed in the environmental issues. But the most important thing is we are trying to break that dilemma that prevails since probably two or three decades, in which it is not possible to reach economic growth and at the same time to be responsible with the environment. And what we are emphasizing is that is false. It's a false dilemma. It is possible to get economic growth, and at the same time it is possible to reduce carbon emissions, for instance, and to reduce the risk associated with climate change. So it is important to put this emphasis in the business orientation, pro-growth orientation about climate. It's not a question about science. It is also a question of real development, and we believe, we are sure, that it is possible to reach both environmental and economic responsibility. So yes, it's good decision for the university, for the school, and of course for the business roundtable in the States to take such decision.
What do you feel about the rollback in environmental protections that we are seeing, not just in this country, but in other countries around the world as well? This is surely turning back the hands of time.
Yeah, unfortunately there are some setbacks here in the States and other countries. But the important thing is I can observe a permanent trend in the right direction. Mm-hmm. So the big question is not if the world is going to change to be more sustainable or not, but if are we going to be on time to do so? That's the real question. So in the positive side, I can say that new generations, your students, for instance, I'm very sure, are much more committed than anyone, than the previous one, than our generation, for instance. And I believe that is going to have an important role in politics. I don't know if today or next election, next year, but in the future, definitely. And that will change the route we are taking today. They are just maybe one step forward, one step backwards, but in the long term, we can make a difference, but in order to do so, we can show how to do that. How can we achieve the most legitimate interests of the people related with job creation, for instance, mm-hmm. or fighting poverty, or even profits in a company? But we can do that with responsibility.
One last question before we move on to another topic, but perhaps one or two specific recommendations that you would give our business students, problems that are critical in this area that they should work on, that they should be thinking about to make a difference, because they do, as you say, all want to make a difference.
Well, universities like this can make an enormous difference researching about the correlationship between business and economic growth and environmental issues. Mm-hmm. But to be honest, I think what we need to do is to emphasize in a new narrative. So instead to talk about how horrible is hell of climate change, it's time to talk about the beautiful paradise, the promised land we have ahead. Mm-hmm. So in order to do that, we need to emphasize the economic benefits of being responsible. For instance, in solar energy. No? 10 years ago, when I tried as president to put the first facility of solar cells power generation plant, it was like a 10 times more expensive than today. Today, it's much more cheaper, and you can get incredible good business, profitable, and at the same time, to reduce enormously carbon emissions. Mm-hmm. Or maybe you can focus the emphasis of your students and teachers in the low-hanging fruits, for instance. What are those measures that are really good for businesses, but also good for the environment? For instance, retrofitting I don't know, this university or any building of in Miami, for instance, that it could imply at net present value in the future huge savings for either the company or the university, but also huge reduction of carbon emissions. So it's a win-win situation, mm-hmm. and a business school, like the business school in University of Miami, could make a difference. I'm providing some guidance to the public and to the business mm-hmm. sector about economic benefits of being responsible.
I'm proud to inform you that this 40-year-old building just received LEED Gold certification for operations and maintenance.
That's fantastic.
First university building in Florida to receive that recognition.
Congratulations.